You can probably tell that I'm really tired. Today I am doing a diagnosis story. Well, diagnosis story, it's more like a timeline. Diagnosis timeline. Little heads up at the beginning. My diagnosis has changed a stupid amount since I was 13 years old to now. It has changed so much. I do want to say this as well. Do not take this as self-diagnosing, professional advice. Take this as me sharing part of my life, and maybe it's a little bit educational about other mental health conditions. These conditions have all been diagnosed by mental health professionals. So I'm going to start with at 13 years old when I was diagnosed with bipolar type 1. So I was diagnosed with bipolar 1 when I was experiencing my first major psychotic episode, which consisted of me following a glowy light and moving shadows. The moving shadows, I'll get onto in a bit because that still happens to me. I'm not chasing any glowing light, and I'm not convinced my family are trying to poison me anymore. In case you didn't know, it's my little segment. I got very deep into delusions and hallucinations. It was chaos because I was hearing voices, but I was also young enough to not really understand mental health. Also, my family history is basically bipolar. My mom's bipolar, both my grandparents have bipolar, and then my grandma's mother, so my great nan, had bipolar. Basically, bipolar runs so strongly in my family that it would be pretty much impossible for me not to have it. I believe there is some mental illness on my dad's side of the family, but I don't have any contact with them, so I don't know. That's a story for another video, why I don't talk to my dad's side of the family. I was on two medications for bipolar initially. I was on lithium. Didn't last very long. I got very dehydrated, and dehydration, generally speaking, isn't a good thing. And then I got started on 2-Depakote, which, as far as I'm aware, is actually an anticonvulsant. Well, it's used for bipolar treatment, and I took that for over a year. That was that. Between the ages of 14 and 16, I got diagnosed with anxiety. I had bipolar already diagnosed, and I became anorexic, and I didn't eat at all. I never ate a single meal while I was in secondary school at that school. It got to a point where I couldn't bring myself to eat, and my mom sat me at a table and said, "You're not leaving until you ate," and I literally picked the plate up and threw it across the room, and I went, "There we go, it's empty," and I just walked out the house. The anxiety, in looking at it from how my life has been, I'd say I've always gone with anxiety, and I definitely do still now. Like, this morning I was up at work, and I something I was supposed to do, and then I was freaking out about maybe I didn't do it right, and that's still playing on my mind, but oh well. With anxiety, I currently take medication for this. I take clonazepam for my anxiety 3 times a day, though I honestly forget to take it. I always remember the evening dose, but the ones that was 7 a day, apart from today I forget normally. Yeah, that shows how addictive that is. So let's move on to when I was 17 18. Now around this, you can probably tell that I'm really tired. Said a lot of things happened, right? A lot of things. In my opinion, I think I should have been diagnosed with PTSD then. Well, I wasn't. I was diagnosed with borderline personality disorder, depression, anxiety, EDNOS, insomnia, and bipolar. I was a complete mess. I've told this story a few times, but during that time frame, one of my exes committed suicide in front of me, and that was point blank traumatizing, to be honest. And around that age, I became really hard to be around. I just cried all the time. Like, I was miserable. I don't know, it's kind of scary to look back at then, and I'm just like, oh my god. I can literally see in photos, like, how much I didn't care. My sleep was an issue then. Like, I've been on sleeping tablets for like 4 years nearly, which is quite a long time, but they still work. And honestly, I can't sleep without taking something. But around that age, I really, really began to struggle with my mental health, and that's kind of when I started this channel. So the depression became very obvious. You could tell from how I acted, from my lack of motivation, walking out of college, overdosing. Self-harm is probably its worst then as well. Like, it was a horrible time. So now we're gonna fast forward to between the ages of 18 and 22. I'm 22 now. So between the ages of 18 and 22, a lot happened. My diagnosis as it stands is DPDR, which is depersonalization and derealization, PTSD, anxiety, depression, borderline, and bipolar. And I'm pretty sure I'm still diagnosed with EDNOS because I keep getting given nutrition shakes, and they are starting to really do my head in. The new diagnosis came around after the 16th of the 6th, 2016. 2018, which was the day that a lot of shit went wrong. Like, that day, there's a reason I can remember that day, and that is because that is the day I got arrested. And I got arrested because I was seeking, and I got assaulted when I was in custody. I don't want to sit and talk about that more than what I have to. I'm not comfortable talking about it, really. All charges against me got dropped and thrown out of court. They literally got left out of court. The magistrate sided with me, the prosecution sided with me. There really wasn't any evidence against me. The evidence my solicitor used was my own custody record, which I did read out in a live stream last year. After that incident, I got diagnosed with depersonalization and derealization. That's because I was dissociating a lot. And one of the main incidents that I remember is where I saw ghost people. But this is a story. So story time. I was out walking. I did that a lot when I lived in Lancashire. I used to go out for walks every night. I'd walk 16,000 steps-ish in a day. Like, I'd walk a lot. So this night I was out walking and I saw a person. Or at least I thought I did. At least I thought I saw a person. And then they half disappeared. And you know in films when someone goes like ghost outlining? I saw that. And because of how real it felt and literally seeing this happen, so it's not like it was in my head, I was physically seeing it. I ended up running around a random estate in Preston that I honestly, I've tried looking on maps, right, to try and find out where the hell I was, and I have never been able to work it out. Running around there, and I literally phoned the police saying, I'm gonna sound crazy, there are ghost people chasing me. And then these ghost figures turned into birds that were flying off lampposts into me, and I remember screaming. I broke my phone that night as well. I woke up in the morning and I thought all that was a dream. Only when I went out on my phone and checked my call log that I saw the number that I called. It's 3 digits. I was like, oh, that actually happened. And that was a long time ago. But I've had similar incidents happen to that. Yeah, that was the night. I wish I could say it was because of drugs and alcohol, but it really wasn't. Because that was around the time that I completely just stopped using cocaine. And again, that is a story for another time. I also stopped drinking around the same time. I got diagnosed with PTSD technically last year because everyone until that point had said, oh, it's just a PPD. Like, it was very obvious. And I have been saying the same thing since the beginning of it all. There's a lot of diagnoses there. I'm not convinced that I agree with all of them, but they are all there. I do take medication to manage my mental health, and I have no regrets in saying that at all. So my diagnosis is still open to change, and honestly, I expect it will, because there are a lot of things that could kind of merge into one diagnosis, but I'm not a professional. I'm going to leave that business down to them. If you are interested in what medications I take, I did make a separate video talking about psychiatric medication. So this is a brief timeline of like my diagnosis. Obviously things have changed, a lot of things have changed, and like I said, I expect they'll continue to change, because really with mental health, you're not treating the condition, you are treating the symptoms that present. I said this back when I was first diagnosed with BPD, it's not about treating the disorder, is about treating the symptoms of it, trying to treat the symptoms, not the disorder. As I'm sure most of you know, BPD has got no licensed medication to treat it, but a lot of people with BPD are on medication for the depression, for the anxiety, for the dissociation, for coping with things. Like, there are medications to help with the symptoms, and I think that's just the thing that should be shown across mental health. There is no pill that someone could give me that would stop the PTSD. There is no pill that exists that will get rid of the bipolar. There's no pill that exists that will get me over the dissociation. You know, that's life, and you know, that's... And I hope this video has been educational in some way, or insightful. Insightful, that's the right word. New video coming out tomorrow. I'm posting it every day at the minute because I'm working early and kind of need something to fill my afternoon with. So, not sure what I'm doing tomorrow for tomorrow's video, but we'll cross that bridge when I get to it. So for now, if you are new, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Also, if you didn't know, I have a merch shop. Insert photo here. My medication can't control your stupidity, because it can't. I also sell stickers and other fun stuff over on there. I'll make sure that's linked in the description down below. And if you want to become a Patreon, That link is also down below. Any and all support of this channel is hugely appreciated. Whether it's a comment, whether it's a share, whether you become Patreon, whether you hit the like button. Every little thing helps, and that's where I'm going to end the video. Peace.